Looking for a free and easy website? Stick around.
So first things first, we go to the homepage of Canva. And in the homepage, you can find templates by either going up to templates and website is under the business and then website. Or you can just go into this search box and click websites, which you can see I've already done that. You can type it in if not. And the website templates will come up. If you have a business already, you probably know what you want your website to do. But if you're thinking about what possibilities could there be for a Canva website, just have a look here at the themes and view more, and you can see all the different kinds of businesses where a Canva website could be useful.
So what kinds of websites could this actually create? It would be really useful if your business was lead generation and you just needed a quick site that was a punchy sales page and for somebody to click a link over to somebody else that was a registered lead generation site and you got a commission for that. It would also be good if you were doing some sort of affiliate marketing and you were just making some recommendations and you wanted it to click out to your affiliate partner or to your Amazon shop. Let's say you're an author and you've self-published a book on Kindle Direct Publishing or one of these other options, you can actually do a mock-up of the cover of your book on here, put it on your website, and link out to your Kindle page on Amazon where you're selling the page, or sorry, where you're selling the book, and then you can use that as your author's website as well. So that's incredibly handy for an author or an artist. The other option here is that Stripe have a Stripe checkout product. So if you don't want to use another platform as your hosting platform like Etsy or Redbubble or one of the affiliate marketing sites, but you have a product that you want to do a market test with, or you already know you want to sell it, you can create the product pages and the product profiles on your free Canva website and then link out to your Stripe account. Now, it's not great if you have a lot of products, but if you were, for example, selling just a drop shipped product where it's a white label product and you've branded it on your own and the whole website is about that, or if you're selling a subscription service and you just have a couple tiers that somebody could choose, then it should be able to actually work for those kinds of more simple sites. If you're an artist and you're taking a commission, then you could have somebody prepay for something, or you can have your prepaid list of pre-orders for a new product launch that you're going to do, something like that. So there are lots of options, even if you want to use this for something that the features aren't specifically on Canva right now. Because of that hyperlink function, you can use it for a lot of different things. This would also be great for a real estate agent. There's an integration with Google Maps that you can use to show where the listing is, and you can put the listing photos up there. If you have it listed on another site that you've paid for, you can put the link over from there and have somebody click in. You can have them set an appointment with you. If you're doing a research project, for example, you could click it out to your Google Forms. This would also be useful if you're a teacher, a tutor, a coach, and you have some fenced off content that's specifically for a certain group of people. You can use this as a front end. Of course, when you publish the website, you can set up a password to actually get into the website, or when you click the hyperlink, you can bring it out to a different service that could also be password protected, or only those with a link are able to get in there, and you've got the password protection on your Canva account. Definitely you can make money through having a free Canva website.
But I'm gonna click launching soon. And you could use this, for example, if you've bought a domain and you want a little bit of a placeholder that's not the 404 of needing to be redirected if you're not done with your main website creation. If you were trying to monetize a website through a blog or something like that. And one of the first things you'll notice in this template is that in the background, there's a video already embedded into it. which is one of the great features of Canva. I can click videos at the side here, and once it takes a little bit of a second to load, you'll be able to see that there are a number of videos within Canva that are options for you to use on your website, and you can just replace this video with one of those. And then you have that kind of interactive hero at the top of this. Now, the websites for Canva, the way that Canva described them, is a beautiful, responsive, one-page site. So what that is just like an endless scroll site, and I'll show you a little bit more how to do the endless scroll. And as a free user, you can create up to 5 pages. But let's say we want this to be a little bit bigger. We click on it, this little line appears, and we can stretch it out. On a video, it'll reduce the quality of the video if we zoom in a lot. But if you had something else here, a different image, you could do that instead. Or let's just pretend that you have 3 different options for a subscription service. Now, let's say this is going to be your button. You want to highlight the whole button that is the first tier of your subscription service and group. Once it's grouped, you can make that thing into a link, making the whole thing a hyperlink. With a subscription service, you can link it to your payment provider. Stripe have this Stripe checkout program that lets you use or house your payment and checkout cart system just on Stripe, so that you don't have to host it on your own website. And you can hyperlink it back out to your Stripe checkout account, so that when they've chosen a certain thing, it goes directly into that checkout process, and Stripe's design stops you from losing people within the checkout process, allows them to pay with Google Pay or their credit card, and it'll get paid into your account from Stripe. So even though e-commerce features aren't enabled on the site, because you have this hyperlink option, there are so many possibilities for ways that you can enable e-commerce through the free Canva website. You just go down here and click more, these 3 little dots, and you can see that there are a few integrations that are very easy through the Canva platform. And again, this is beta, so I would expect that they would come out with better functionality as time goes on, but what's there now is great. So you click Google Maps and just choose one of these. You can put your address in there, and let's say our address is the Colosseum. You can resize this, and it's interactive, just like it would be on any other site, where you can see what's around there and get directions to the location or things like that. So that's another great way to get an integration to give this site more functionality and more feeling of a full-fledged site that you might see on a more expensive website builder. Another option is if you're a content creator. So you just click on YouTube, and it lets you search for YouTube videos right in the search bar here on Canva. So I'll just search for my channel, and it comes right up. Here's a couple of my recent videos, and I can resize them and embed them directly in the web page. So if you were trying to have a website that was there to promote your brand on a different platform like YouTube, and you had these kinds of things, that would also be a great option. Or maybe you decided to add an extra section to your website. Up here, you can see some hyperlinks were created to the pages at the bottom. So now we're happy with our website, and we want to just do a couple finishing touches of making it compliant with our brand. So if you go into styles over here, you can see that I've set up a brand kit on Canva already, which is done through the homepage. And you can just click brand colors, apply to all pages, and it automatically updates the whole website template to your brand colors without you having to do any of the work. I have never seen this so easy on any other website builder. That gives you a great start for how you can actually set this up to be something that's more personal to you and your business. So now we're ready to click publish. And if you're finding this video helpful and inspiring for how easy it is to create a free website, click that like button. That'll help this video spread to more people and help more people to get the advantages of the new Canva sites that you are getting right now. And I'm happy with it. I think it all looks great. I'm gonna go ahead and click publish as a website. And then we start to see the options for how to publish. Now, this is the beta version. So you can see there are two options. One is free domain, which Canva gives you a subsite on their own site. And the other is purchase a new domain through Canva. Once this actually live updates into the full-fledged version, what you'll see is there'll be an option there to link to an existing domain that you already own. That's what I would personally recommend. And the main reason for that is to have an email address associated with your domain. I actually don't know whether or not that'll be available through what Canva are offering, but I would just make sure that you have that. Now, there are lots of different services that offer domains. When I was buying domains, I made the mistake of buying most of my domains through a service that didn't offer emails. GoDaddy does have an email that comes with it when they sell a domain, and it's not more expensive. You just have to use the Microsoft Office 365 suite, or if you have it on your computer, you can use that. But right now, we're just going to click free domain and continue. And then we have this option of your URL, and we want to edit it. This is the subsite that Canva have issued to me, and this is the extension to the subsite. You can see that right now it matches the file name on the website, but I want it to be something a little bit snappier. But still keep in mind that the title of the domain does help you in your search engine optimization. And then we get into browser tab and preview, edit. Here you can change the favicon. So you can easily design a favicon in Canva if you don't already have one. What the favicon is just that little icon that comes up on the little tabs at the top of the browser. And so you want it to be unique to you. For example, if you were to get a free WordPress site, it always has the WordPress favicon at the top. So this is actually a much better option than doing something like that, because it does let you have a little bit more branding on it than a different kind of site like that would have. Then you titled the website Dr. Bob's Office. And that would come up as the title of your website in the search engine results page if somebody were looking for your office. And then the site description, again, that comes up in Google and is useful for the search engine results page. But I'm just going to click publish. So now you've got your website, but you want to make some edits to it. So we come home in Canva. And we go to the little gear option. And at the left-hand side in the menu here is domains. We click domains and we want to manage the domains that we have. So I have a couple designs in here. I'm going to go to these three dots at the side and click edit design. And to unlock the website, because it's locked right now, I click edit design again. And at that point, then I can change anything, move it around, redo the hyperlinks that are there if you've updated something, change out the photos, that kind of stuff, or if you've moved location, put in your new location into your Google map that you have there. So it's really easy to do. At the end, then you just publish as a website again and continue. You can view your website just to make sure that the changes happened properly and all looks great. And we're all set. It didn't take us very long at all. Make the hyperlink different or go down to that section in the menus here by making this hyperlink link to a different section. So I'm unlinking it here. I've clicked remove, and now I can decide that instead of going to remove, it goes to support. Go to page, and it's down there. If it's a new section, then I want to add the page. I would copy and paste that background so that it's the same as the rest of the website, if that's what you have. Or you can use the eyedropper to change colors. And you can go here, and I would rename that reviews. And now it links down to reviews. Just to make sure it works, we're going to push preview and click it. And you can see it brings us down to that page where you can put your customer testimonials and reviews. The other thing you can see when you click previews is the different responsive options. So you can see what it looks like on desktop, tablet, or mobile. And you can scroll through. It goes automatically to a centered inline view of everything. It does not, however, in the beta version anyway, let you edit by device. You have to edit the whole thing or nothing. But at least it'll show you if there's something that looks very off in the way that the website is set up. I'm going to close this. At this point now, there are a couple different options for what you want to do if you have a free website, but you want to kind of hide the messy subsite on the Canva site. The two options I would recommend are to come into a service like your Google domain and then put in the website URL from Canva. What it does is then if somebody goes to your main site website, if you want to provide the main site of a domain that you already own as a link to somebody else, when they go to that link, it'll auto redirect to your Canva site so that you can provide the kind of nice looking, pretty branded link, but actually where they end up is on your Canva site. If you don't already own a domain and you don't want to spend the $12 a year to buy one, then you can do something like a bit.ly link that you can use in your social medias if you're tweeting something out or if you wanted to put it as a link in your Instagram or something like that.
We'll be reviewing some other options to do websites, and then we'll have a little bit of a roundup over the next few weeks of the different options there are to create your own website, how you might be able to integrate them together, and how they compare with each other.
Canva sites, so easy, so many free options, and they're about to go live with the main version. You've got a sneak peek. You can get in there early and build your site on Canva for free. Good luck with it. Let us know in the comments below what kind of website you ended up building. And if you were inspired by this, share it with a friend. Good luck.